Take care of. Okay. Well, yes, just like Marissa said, let's kick off with prayer, just that this night would be fruitful. Lord, we thank you so much for each and every person on this call and that might would watch the recording. Lord, we just thank you that you have dropped something so special into our laps. Lord, we want to give you all the glory for the growth that happens in our businesses, for the growth that happens in us personally, Lord, that we know that you have set aside this season of life and this company with these people in these communities, Lord, that you would be doing a work in us and through us for your glory and for the good of others. We just thank you and we praise you that you have given us this. And we pray that you would use this time to help us steward our hearts and our minds well, that we would desire to steward our businesses well that you have given us. And Lord, that you would help us to continue to have a passion to use this assignment that you've given us to reach others in their health, their finances, and ultimately to relieve burdens in their life that they may encounter you in a much more real way. So, Lord, we thank you for this opportunity and this evening, and may it be fruitful and glorifying to you. And it's in Christ's name we pray. Amen. Well, I am so grateful to be here. Obviously, a huge fan of y'all's team. I'm just scrolling up and down looking at all your faces. So if you can pop on your video, that's awesome. But just, watching, I've been following Marissa for a long time. I've been with Plexus almost 9 years. So I joined in 2015, I think. Yes, the end of 2015. Yeah, it's just been a crazy wild ride. And something I'm so thankful for in my life is that I never really stuck with anything before Plexus. I've been one of those like, oh, I'm a Renaissance person. I like to do this and I'm going to change and do this. And I feel like something that the Lord has taught me over the last 9 years is how to dig in and not give up when things get hard. Because I think it was just more fun and easier to do that my whole life of like, okay, college was fun while it was great. And then I don't want to take those classes. So I'm going to change and do this instead. I'm going to go do this. This is fun, or this job got hard. Cool. I can go find a different one, and this unique opportunity has been one that I've not been able to rightly walk away from ever when things good, when things are hard, or any of that. And I think the Lord has developed and is continuing to develop within me steadfastness and faithfulness and all of these things that are so important to our walk, to our personal lives, but for sure to our business. But so yes, my family, my husband and I lived in Zambia, Africa for 2.5 years, which is where Kim Cheryl is on here. She is my sapphire. Level one, and that is where we met. She was on a short-term trip while we lived over there. But when we came back to the States, we felt the Lord calling us back into worship ministry. That's what our family does. That's what we do now. I just was sick and tired, and I was like, my daughter is 15 months old. How long do I get to say baby weight? And I'm just tired because I have a baby. She wasn't really a baby anymore. And I just knew like I had spent all of this time learning about and seeing the just gloriousness of who God created us to be and his creation and preaching the gospel and all of these things. And I came back to the States and I was just like, what is my body doing? Like, who am I? This is not who God created me to be. And so through that experience and getting, connected with the products because of seeing, someone that I've met also in Zambia posting on Facebook, Abby Capo is my sponsor who I signed up with 9 years ago. And she was on a short-term trip in Africa too. That's how we got connected on Facebook. And so, side note, you just never know who the Lord's going to connect you with. And so be kind, connect and love people well. It may be years down the road, like it was for Abby, that the Lord was doing something in her life and, providing for her and her family, that this opportunity presented itself way after we met in Africa, right? And same thing for Kim. After the Lord was doing this in our lives, it presented an opportunity for me to be able to connect back with Kim. And so, whatever job you're in, whatever season of life, or whatever neighborhood you're in, or the lady at Walmart who you're like, I think I'm supposed to just talk to that lady. You just don't know what God's doing for others and for yourself. So, listen to the Holy Spirit and just obey. But yeah, so I started the product, and I always tell the story, with my team, but it's just kind of like this like fire got lit up within me of just I just got mad because I felt sick and horrible. And I was like, this is how the enemy shuts us down. You know, this is how he takes out the army of God, is by making us sick and tired. And then he makes us focus on being sick and tired. So that's all we care about. And we can't care about anyone else. And we don't care. We don't care about our neighbors. We don't care about the work or the ministry of the church. And even if we do care, we can't do anything about it if we're sick and tired and can't leave our house. Right. So I just kind of got angry and started being like, wait, all these testimonies, all of these different people are taking the same thing that I'm taking, and they're seeing this, 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 and this. And like, that is not right that we didn't learn this in school. People are lying to us. I mean, I can conspiracy theory with the best of them, but ultimately, this is a tool to enrich people's lives and to equip the saints to further the kingdom of God by setting them free in these areas. And I have seen that over and over and over again over the last 9 years of our team, and how God uses this in people's different seasons of their business and how he's done it for us. So our team went Emerald in 18 months. And so in 2017, shout out for convention. Doesn't matter what rank you are, get yourself to Las Vegas, because I will say I did not know anybody on my team, because Abby lived in Arkansas. Like I said, I met her in Africa. We were not connected. I did not know her from Beans, which meant I knew none of my uplines or sidelines, Jessica, Heffley, Tamara, all of them, all lived in Arkansas. And so by the time 2016 rolled around, I had signed up for convention just to like not miss out, just in case I wanted to go. But I was like, I'm definitely not going. But I was Ruby by the time May came around, and I was like, well, I guess I should go. Like, I don't even know what I'm doing, and I should probably like show up for this thing so my team like feels connected to it, because you know, no one else is gonna go with me. And so I went and got connected with some of my sidelines and had a great time. But what it did for me was allowed me to catch a vision for who I wanted to be and what God was going to develop in me with this business. Because when we're at home, like, we get part of it and we love our like team culture. We love like, oh, look at this thing that I'm building. This is so fun. And then you get there and you're like, dang, this is so bigger and special than I realized. And so I saw all the jewels and diamonds sitting on the floor level and like in the special seats. Right. And then I was like, next year I'm going to be sitting down there. And sure enough, 2017, when my flight landed in Las Vegas, I opened my screen and it was at 1507, and we had become an Emerald team exactly a year later from our first convention. And it was just the most special thing ever. And so thankful. Went Diamond in 2020. And just so you know too, like, all of my jewels that are here with me now, were not even gold when I went Emerald. I think some of them even joined after I went Emerald. And so that is also just a lesson that I always want to remind our team, but I remind you too, is like, you keep being faithful where you're at, and you be a lighthouse, because as people come in their seasons of running, and as God's using this in their life, your team will be comprised. I'm not going to say the people who helped you here won't be with you, but they may not be the ones running. They may be in a different season. They may go through something in their life to where that's not, you know, their main thing anymore, or may go through something tragic or something like that. But you will continue to have people that God brings into your life to grow this, if you will remain faithful and you remain that lighthouse that people will also come back to as well, because that happens all the time. But yeah, so here we are in, like I said, lots of different seasons of my life, you know, been through hard seasons, and the freedom that this has provided our family to not literally not settle for God less than God's best for us. Sorry, that was really hard to spit out. I couldn't figure out how I wanted to say that. You know, when we moved back from Africa, we knew we were called to worship ministry. We didn't have a job lined up. We were literally like playing guitar on the side of the road, like, everybody, don't you want to worship with us before work in the morning? And they're like, nope. We're like, what? We did this in Africa. This was so great. And we're like, okay, Lord, what are we doing here? But as he provides that, like, we have now been able to follow God's call on our life, because we're not settling for a paycheck. We don't have to sit somewhere under, you know, bad leadership, or where we don't feel like we're being fruitful and helping the mission or ministry of the church we're serving, if we're not really supposed to be there, but we're like, but they pay good, or, you know, but we won't be able to afford this if we, you know, don't leave. And it's like, we trust the Lord, and he has given us this as provision to be able to release those things and be able to follow him where we're supposed to go. So we moved to Georgia in 2018, and Brandon took like a very minimal part-time worship position and was getting paid like $700 a month. But we're just like, we just want to serve. Like, we just want a place to be able to use our gifts and plug in. And God has absolutely blossomed that ministry. And, you know, Brandon's full time there now. And we have like worship, you know, CD out and like all of these crazy things that are just big God-sized dreams that because of my obedience through Plexus and sticking with it and diving in when things got hard and, you know, all of the, we have been able to see God bring fruit to other areas of ministry in our life as well. And we can talk more, you know, questions later about like, obviously monetarily, this means that our kids are able to go to a Christian private school because I'm not a great school mom. That was not my forte. When Brandon was part-time, he did that. And that was awesome. He's a great teacher. Me, not so much. But it has given us the freedom to make these kinds of choices for our family that, you know, we literally had zero income when we came back from Africa. We lived there on the support of other people. Like, they were giving tithes and things so that we could live. And within 2 years, God has completely shifted that. And now, years later, we support other families that we served with there. And to be on the other end of that is just super, super cool. But I'll let Marissa kind of take back over in a second. But some of the things that I just wanted to like let you guys in on is it really is all about action, you know, whether it's action of the heart, action of the mind, action of our fingertips on the keyboard. It really is all about action. I wrote these five things down just before the call, but it's about obedient action. When you know that the Lord is tugging on you to do something, to go after it, he tells us to walk by faith, not by sight. He tells us to walk in faith. And something I also talk about to him a lot is by faith and not by feedback. And that to me is always a really good reminder because sometimes I'm doing things and saying, how did that go? Did everybody like that? Or, you know, did people show up for this? Or did anyone respond to this? And God's not saying, hey, do other people like this? Then obey me. Or then, you know, be faithful in this. He's saying, did I ask you to do this? Then be faithful. He's saying, did I tell you to walk through this path? Then walk it out, whether or not someone said good job or not, you know. Take courageous action because obedience takes courage. And it's courageous to step out into our comfort zone or to step out of who this shell of a person of who we thought we were supposed to be. Y'all, I went to school for opera. Like, I was a vocal performance major, have no business background training, like did not even finish college. Thank you very much. It takes courage to step out and say, okay, Mary, and now I'm selling stuff on Facebook. But I had to understand that God put this in front of me. Then he was going to carry me through it. And courage is doing stuff scared. It's not saying, oh, well, obviously this is easy and fun and not scary at all. But then we also have to take disciplined action because discipline is a hard thing for me. But it is something that is so important and is a fruit of the spirit, y'all. It is a fruit of the spirit to be self-disciplined. And it is something that I think we should pray over ourselves and for ourselves and our family and our children is the discipline that the Lord and the Holy Spirit can help us to achieve. Because it is about doing things when you don't feel like it. It's about showing up when you don't feel it. It's about believing that something is true, even if you don't believe that it's true for yourself in that moment, knowing that something is true or possible when you don't feel it. Being disciplined to do the things now that will bring the fruit of what you know is possible later on. And it's to take purposeful action, not willy-nilly, something that Genevieve says a lot. And I just love is when she's like, don't just get on the plane and invite people on this plane trip to nowhere, like know where you're going, like where is the destination, know what you're working for, know what your purpose is for your family, have that shareholder meeting, know what your purpose is in helping other people get well, like what makes that a personal connection for you that you have purpose in sending messages. What is your purpose in growing your business and your income? And what do you want? It can be some fun, selfish stuff. Like, that's okay to be like, I want to go to Hawaii. That's okay. You know, it doesn't always have to be like this high spiritual thing. You cannot separate the two. And that's something that we remind ourselves about on our team too. Like, your mission and your work that you're doing to love other people out will never be separated from the mission and the work that God is doing in you and through you. Even if you don't know it, he is going to work through to reach the people that he wants to reach. And just like in Esther, we get to say, okay, it will be me. You can work through me because I'm going to show up, right? It's not going to be where Mordecai tells her, God's going to do this, but are you going to let him use you to do it, right? He's going to help that mama that he intends to be on these products, or he's going to help that family that's struggling and is going to need a diamond income at some point. But is it going to be because you were faithful and showed up to help that, you know, process, or will he use someone else, right? So be purposeful in that. And then resolved action. Are we resolved to not quit? Are you resolved that this is just part of who you are, not just like, well, I'm going to try this, I'm going to dabble in this for a little while. Are we resolved that, like, I'm proud of this? And that's a resolve that I found early on, but it's something that I've had to continue to cling to over 9 years, right? Because resolve can be strong in one moment, but it can fade over time. And so that resolve for me early on was like, I believe that I can wear Plexus gear and wear my Plexus hat and talk about Plexus at church because I believe that it is enriching the lives and blessing the lives of the people that I speak to about it, right? So I'm resolved to be your crazy Plexus friend. That's okay. And I'm resolved that this is my job when people ask me what I do. I'm resolved to say that this is part of who I am because it's what God has given me. It's the assignment that he's put before me right now. And I'm going to be okay with that, right? I'm taking on that as part of my identity for this season while God has this for me, right? So those are just some of the things, but it's all action. It's all activity-based. The passivity in our lives is something that we have to pray away because that is hesitancy and fear, and we do not serve a God of fear and chaos and confusion. So anyway, that's my 50 cents.
I love you so much. Okay, so last thing I want you to share, what advice would you give, you being in this 9 years, I've been in this 6 years, and like you said, some of these people that got you to Emerald may not even be with you now, they may still be using the products, you know, all the things, but what advice would you give to somebody that is scared of, okay, I have this dream, but what if it fails? They're scared to jump all in belief wise. They're scared to go all in on their social media, you know, because they have that fear of failing. What advice would you give for that?
I would say it's always about capturing your thoughts, right? So who are listening to, what are you filling your mind with? What are you watching? Who are we letting speak into our lives, whether it's consciously or subconsciously? Because, you know, we can get sassy and be like, those people don't pay your bills. That's true. That is true. But those people are not Lord of your life. If you're a Christian, what are you making Lord of your life? And ultimately, that is something we've got to discipline ourselves for, is who are we allowing to direct our steps? Fear directing our steps is a tool of the enemy, and your steps will definitely slow down when you allow those things, because he doesn't want good for your life. He doesn't want good things for you, and he doesn't want you to do good things for others. And so for me, it is really just always about going back and capturing those thoughts and tracing it back to, what am I afraid of? And am I just like, okay, and settling that I'm just scared? Because a lot of times that root cause, all of these like actions and inactions that are spiraling around up here, it's not because you're ADD. It's not because you're not cut out for this. It's not because you don't have a degree. It's not this, it's this. And when you boil it all down, it's fear of something, right? It's fear of rejection, or it's shame, or it's, you know, I'm not good enough, or people are going to make fun of me, or my siblings are, you know, totally hate that I'm doing this. I'm embarrassing my family. Like, that's all fear-based, right? Like, it's all under here. So whatever's going on up here, or why can't I just stick with this? Or why can't I just, you know, send the messages? Or why can't I ever stick with this thing? Like, spiral that down. What's going on in your heart? And say, you're not Lord. You're not Lord of my life. And then choose to fill your mind with uplifting things. That is a disciplined and courageous and purposeful action, is when you're to intentionally change those thoughts. The Lord says, take your thoughts captive, right? And write them to the truth of Christ. So that was a long.
Oh, I love it. I love that. And I think we, as just selfish humans, get so wrapped up. Like, I love that you said obedient action by faith and not by feedback. How many of you have literally been like, I don't want to post because I'm not going to get that many likes, or I'm not going to do this because I'm afraid that somebody's going to say this, or why is nobody commenting on my post? Like, the fact
that video's not on.
Like, I'm so thankful that you said that, because I think we all just needed that reminder of, like, we need to step in.
Have a little glass of milk.
Let this call be a reminder to step into faith in the month of April. Like, some of you are like, well, I haven't signed up anybody, so I'm not going to earn the walking pad. You're claiming that now, and it's only April 10th, y'all. Like, there's still how many weeks left? And so stepping into faith, being bold. So a little backstory on who I am. And actually, I met Sally. Those of y'all that are on Sally's team, it is such a blessing to know her, like, as a sideline, as, like, someone that's followed her for years. I'll never forget, like, going to the, I think it was Jewels of Excellence, or maybe it was convention, I don't remember, but you spoke and you wore this really pretty pink bubblegum dress. And I was like, I want to be her. Like, she's my diamond inspiration. And so when we talked about collaborating a team call together, it was just really cool, because watching her in Hawaii and Mexico, and, like, these baptisms of her, you know, leading the worship, and, like, literally a cappella, people's hands in the air raised. Like, it's such a special feeling of, I'm in the right place. I'm with the right company. Like, y'all know, you see these companies come and go, and Plexus is just so special. And so she's absolutely right. If you are not registered for convention, get to convention. You can room with somebody. I'm sure people have, like, earned the free room. You can figure something out there. Like, that is where it changed everything for me. I went as a gold. So I joined in 2016. I'm 30 years old, and I joined in 2016. I was really young. I had two kiddos. One was 3, one was 6 months. And I just, like Sally said, I thought it was just normal to be a tired mama. I thought it was normal to walk around not motivated to take care of yourself, because you're just a mama, right? I live in a small town. So most everybody walking around in a small town is tired and moody, right? So I just thought that that was normal. And I struggled a lot with anxiety. I'm a suicide survivor. I tried to commit suicide when I was 13. So I'm very big on just mental health and, like, healing. Like you were talking about earlier, it's a heart issue. Y'all, it really is. Like, get to the root of why you want to do this. Get to the root of why you struggle, or what you're afraid of, or, you know, why you struggle with anxiety or depression. Like, it all goes back to maybe some stuff in your childhood, or, you know, maybe trying to prove something. Like, I'm a big mental health advocate. And so after I had Easton, my second son, I had struggled with a lot of postpartum, very low libido. But again, I thought it was natural to feel that way. I thought it was normal. I was going to go get put back on depression and anxiety meds. And I have been on those, y'all. And I know how it makes you feel, the brain fog, the literally no libido. You feel like you're, like, in a bubble. And I did not want to go get put back on those, but I was very against MLM. Like, I'm just gonna be honest. I am an entrepreneur at heart. I'm a photographer. So I had every which direction of people trying to come at me with, hey, do you want to sell my lip gloss? Do you want to sell my shampoo? Do you want to sell my makeup? I was like, no, I don't want to do that. Like, I want to be a photographer. I have a dream to open a boutique. Like, that's who I'm going to be. And that's a pyramid scheme anyway. Like, don't come at me with that, you know? And it was like the Lord. So my cousin, Brittany Callen, who is an Emerald rank ambassador, she's absolutely fabulous. We work so well together. She reached out to me multiple times about Plexus. I shut her down. I feel so bad now, because I'm like, my gosh, like, thank the Lord she kept reaching out to me. So fortune is in the follow-up. Truly, it took her 6 times to get me signed up. I didn't even sign up on my own. I sent her my card info. I was like, okay, we'll see if this really works. Order whatever I need. I started with Triplex. This was before Reset. This was before Vital Biome. Literally, Vital Biome has become one of my favorite products for anxiety and stress and mood. But this was before all of, like, the active energy. And this was literally Triplex, basic Triplex. Fell in love with the products. Y'all know the stories are a lot of the same energy, mood. Like, my husband was like, what is going on with you? You're, like, doing the laundry. You're happy. You actually love me. Like, what is happening here? And I like had this little nudge of, like, Marissa, maybe this is what you're called to do. Like, maybe you're called to share. I went to So I joined in February of 2016. I went to convention in June as a senior gold. And that is where I literally agree with Sally. I saw some of our uplines praying over our team, praying over me, praying over each other. And I was like, that is what I want to do. That is what I want to be. That is the leader that I want to be. And I literally went home. Me and Brittany were like, let's go. Well, I sat at Senior Ruby for 2 years. I went from Senior Ruby back down to Senior Gold Points, and I was content. Okay. I'm not going to lie. Like, I knew I would never quit because let's face it, we love the product, but I was content with making like $800 a month. You know, I was like, okay, this is fine. Like, I'll post once a month or twice a month, like whatever. And I kind of got burnt out at Senior Ruby, 2 years of like smelling emerald and like wanting emerald. But I'm going to be honest with y'all, the Lord knew that I could not be emerald in that season. He really taught me patience. He taught me obedience. He taught me faith. He taught me big, bold faith. And so I was a senior gold in July of, I think, 2018, maybe 2019. And Natalie Passmore, who was my first jewel, reached out to me and she was like, okay, Marissa, I watch your stuff. I see how confident you are in this. I just had a baby. I'm tired of being tired. I want to lose the weight. And I would love to even make money so that I could be at home with him. Like, that's my big dream. She was a teacher at the time. And I was like, light bulb, like business builder. Like, she was a dream girl for me. And I'm going to be honest, y'all, even as a senior Ruby, I did not reach out about the business. And that is a mistake that I made early on. Again, me and Brittany, if y'all don't know, we've kind of taught ourselves everything we know. My nearest diamond is 7 levels up. So we have had to figure it out. And we were determined to figure it out. YouTube videos, podcasts, trainings. But reaching out about the business was something I wasn't confident in because I wasn't clear about where I was headed. I wasn't clear about, you know, why I wanted this income. And so whenever Natalie reached out, I was like, oh, this is going to be awesome. We're going to run together. I was hitting senior gold points in August, went emerald in January that very next year. So senior gold points in August and emerald in January of that following year, like within 4 or 5 months, y'all. It was incredible to see the momentum happen. Well, I went emerald in January, sapphire in March. It was real quick. And then I sat at Sapphire for about 2 years and I went diamond last month. So I want to kind of share like what's working for us and along with like just how you have to create that momentum and you're not always going to be in momentum season. It comes and it goes. Like some people I know, and even like with you, Sally, you were like, you know, we were in momentum season a couple years ago. Now we're kind of learning how to navigate different things. And like, it's such a blessing too, because we can't always be on the mountaintop, you know, like our leadership is truly born in the valleys. Like that grit is developed in the valleys. I'll never forget Christina Williams in Portugal. I earned a top 50 trip with the company. By the way, flights were like $17,000 per couple and like 36 couples went. So y'all do the math. Our company was amazing. I just always like to share that fun fact, because when we opened that email, we were like, what is happening? But anyway, we went on that trip and Christina was asking me about my business and all the things. And she was like, Marissa, I respect more grit than anything else. These people that can go emerald in 6 months, 9 months, a year, that's great. And that's awesome. But I respect more grit than anything else, because when you can stick something out and you can learn and you can build in the trenches and you can figure out how to go from here, that can change everything for your belief, for your mindset, for your business. And so y'all are doing the right thing by getting on a call on a Wednesday night and learning and being inspired and being encouraged. So my first tip for you guys would be, y'all need to go live. Y'all need to go live with another friend and talk about y'all getting paid today, or talk about the reset triplex balance combo. Or go ahead and schedule that out for the rest of April. Schedule a live with another friend, either on our team, on y'all's team, to get whatever that looks like. Me and Sally are going live Friday. I would go live once a week the rest of April, okay? And it is a little scary. You want to make sure that you name it something that people are going to watch. I would keep your live under 10 minutes. When you start going over 10 minutes, people start acting like grandmas and grandpas and falling asleep, and then they they click off of it, right? So I would keep it under 10 minutes and I would talk about what this is doing, and it has to be storytelling. People are really moved by storytelling. So I would go live this week about getting paid, okay? Second thing that I would start doing is getting on the phone with your new VIPs within 24 hours of ordering. I have a checklist that our team uses. I'll send that to you, Sally. I created that. Just kind of like a checklist of like things to go down through. You have to set the expectations up front before they even get their box. Because let's face it, when they order, what are they thinking? This isn't going to work for me. I'm not going to be good at the business. I don't want to post because I don't want to be that girl. I don't want to do this. They're all of these things are spiraling in their mind. So when you set those expectations up front and you say, okay, here's what's going to happen. I want you to do a shout out post, shout me out for helping you get started. Our team personally does a $50 giveaway every month for people that do a shout out post. We draw a winner. So shout out to my friend Sally for helping me get started on some wellness supplements that help with energy, mood, bloat, just all around feeling better. You know, see the comments for a few of my friends' results. And you can post a couple, you know, reset before and afters or whatever that looks like in the comments. But a shout out post is a trickle effect, and it's going to go down through your levels. And that's duplicatable. So shout out post, getting people on the phone. And then we started doing new VIP calls, and we try to do those once a week for new VIPs. So like a Zoom where you get on and you just kind of meet, like a lot of our senior golds and above, we encourage them to do this and to do one of their own. Even if there's five people on, y'all, that's a connection that they get to hear your voice, hear your heart, hear your story. And then Morgan Cox, that's actually how she earned the Silver Star trip. She was doing those new VIP calls, and she was saying in the chat, y'all comment in the chat if you're interested in getting your products paid for, grabbing three friends, earning a walking pad by grabbing six friends. And we're going to go right after this call and go into a group chat, and I'm going to show you guys a posting idea. I'm going to send you a message that you can reach out with. And so there may be two people every VIP call that do that, but they have a team thread where those people get added to, and then they just call within the team thread and they work for like 20, 30 minutes on like, here's a posting idea, here's a message reach out, here's an event that we can schedule next week. Like, it's like boom, 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 action step. You have to remember that when these people are joining, they don't know up front what's going on. You do, but they don't. So you have to like set those expectations. Somebody asked, do they have to have the products in hand? No. I get my people to do a shout out post within 24 to 48 hours. And we just use like, there's a picture, I think, of Triplex Balance. That's really fun. I can send those to you, Sally, kind of like the shout out post and what we use, but those have helped our team a ton. Shout out post, because then we can say, once you have someone interested, here's what you can send them, because you have to give them upfront. Because what are they doing? What are these people doing that just join and then they send somebody info? They're sending them a whole book, right? And then they're scaring them away. And then they're like, well, I'm not good at this. Nobody joined. No, it's because we didn't give them upfront what they needed, because we were being a little lazy. Okay. We were being a little lazy. And I'm saying that because that was literally me, Senior Ruby, for 2 years. Like, I wanted it to be the easiest possible. And I didn't have that obedience of like, let's go and intentionally work, intentionally plan, intentionally, you know, set aside time to do this. Another thing that we are doing, we encourage our Rubies and Senior Rubies to have their own team threads and do a book club and like meet, you know, once a week, as far as like meeting with that book club or sharing or whatever that looks like. These leaders, and y'all, team stuff is great. Team wide stuff is great. But I want y'all to know that when you ask a gold, hey, I want you to host your own 7-day free prayer walk challenge and do a messenger group and invite everybody that wants to be part of that. You could share devotional every day. You can share information about what Plexus is. Those people that are drinking the pink drink can share a selfie in there. You can do a daily check-in at the end. Who did their 10,000 steps today? Like, host a free prayer walk challenge. When they take ownership in that, y'all, it makes them feel like they're on top of the world. You have to think back to when y'all were starting and when y'all were, you know, when y'all were growing as leaders, when Sally may have asked you to do something, you were like, yes, ma'am, I'll do it. Like, I'm excited. And it's like, when you take ownership in that, it gets you excited for more growth and more growth. Okay. So, we're doing a lot of mini events. We do a lot of messenger events. I actually give my people the choice, especially if they're wanting to go silver. I'll say, hey, let's plug you into an event. Would you want to do like a 20-minute wellness Zoom? And I can share a little bit. You can share a little bit. I can interview style you so that you're not doing it on your own. Or we can do a messenger event. Which one do you feel like your people would appreciate more of? So I just think that like those kinds of things are super, super, super important for developing leaders, for making people feel special, that sort of thing. And then I feel like too, Sally, like little mini, like one-on-one coaching. So we started that, we use an app called Calendly. We started that in January, private one-on-one coachings. We actually did like a business basics bootcamp in January of this year, taking it back to the basics, what to do from when you reach out to a person to when you follow up to when you get them signed up. What do you do from there? That was game changer. We offered an incentive prize if they completed January's Business Basics Bootcamp, and it took off because the one-on-one coachings, guess what we got to do? We got to be their like little encourager / therapist / coach / mentor. You know, like we had this opportunity to pray over them. And I know that like there's people on here, Megan Barham, and trying to scroll down and see Kara, Natalie, like my, there's a couple that like, I can point out that I remember those conversations so vividly of like, we got to get in very intentional with like, okay, what are you scared of? Why are you not doing this? Here's what we can do. And you can do a lot more with one-on-one coachings than you can a big team call. Okay. You just can. So set aside time to use that Calendly. You can even use Calendly for your new VIPs. Say, hey, schedule a call with me when you get time. I'd love to just chat with you about life. And you have the opportunity to pray over them. Okay. That's been really big for our business. But you know, another thing too, Sally, I feel like just having that God-sized dream, if y'all haven't read that book, God-sized Dreams, if you have, gift that to your people working the business, like send it to them on Amazon, write a little note in the gift section, tell them you were made for a God-sized dream and I believe in you. Like it's important that we are really inspiring them in that way and making that impact to where they can have a God-sized dream, even as a silver, even as a senior silver, even as a gold. But having that big vision changed everything for me. I remember when I went to Mexico after I went Emerald and Sapphire that year, I went to Mexico and Jordan Roddenberry, Sally, you know how bold she is. She was like, so do you talk on your stories at all about the business, about the money? And I was like, no. And she was like, why? And I said, I don't know, because I'm scared to talk about money. I don't want to brag. I don't want to be that girl. And she was like, that's very selfish. And I was like, and she was like, I'm not saying that to hurt your feelings. I'm saying you have something here that literally people are praying for an answer for, and you're not sharing because you're too afraid of what people think. You're too afraid of the feedback versus bold faith, like what Sally just said. And like, I remember going back to my room and just crying. I was like, Lord, what in the world? And it's because I wasn't clear on where I was going. I really wanted to be a jewel so that I could show people that I was a jewel, so that I could like prove to my small town that I was a jewel. And the Lord really worked on me within those years of like not going diamond right away. Like he's molded me and taught me so much. Like when I did go diamond last month and all of the recognition and all of the love, I cried all day. I was so humble because this has been such a journey of God-sized dreams and faith, like spiritual maturity, to go from somebody that was so anxious and depressed and trying to prove herself and, you know, desiring popularity. They may not be muted. Somebody that desired popularity, somebody that like desired, like, you know, just like I wanted purpose and I wanted, but like, it was, you have to get to a place in your business where you're like, this is what I want to do, why I want to do it. And it's for the Lord. And you have to know that like those hard seasons our teaching seasons. Those hard seasons are going to help you become a jewel and one day teach your team and have a team call that you talk about those hard seasons that you went through. But at the end of the day, quitting cannot be an option. It cannot be an option, because if it is, what kind of faith is that? What kind of faith is that to be like, well, if it doesn't work out, I'm done. That is not bold faith. And let me tell you something, your audience can see that. And that could be why you're not moving forward. Your audience sees your heart. They see you showing up on your stories. They see this bold faith. When you get off this call, I want to challenge everybody here to make a post. Make a post about this call that you had with Sally Lewis and Marissa Adams, Diamond Ambassadors, and what it planted in your heart. What seeds did it plant? How did it convict you? How did it encourage you? You know, where are you going to go from here? People follow people that know where they're going. And we talk about that all the time on my team. Like, people know when you're wishy-washy. And I love that Sally said that earlier. It's like intentional action and like getting into the nit and gritty of like, let me be intentional and work. Like, I'm doing this for the Lord. I'm working for the Lord. I'm not going to be wishy-washy and post once a week or work my business once a week or once a month and then expect a big paycheck or wonder why I'm not moving forward. We have to work as stewards of the Lord and like know that this is kingdom work and that we get to bring people closer to the Lord. And that's been one of my favorite parts. We do a lot of retreats. If y'all have not had a team retreat, do a team retreat, get together, find time where you can be together. I know that's hard sometimes when you're in different states, but like there's nothing like being together. There's nothing like being able to in person pray over each other or have a Sunday morning devotional, you know, that weekend at a cabin or, you know, whatever that looks like. That fire is lit at all of these in-person events. And so, you know, lastly, I want y'all to know, me and Sally can't be with you every day in your pocket, you know, but the Lord can. The Lord can. And as some of y'all look at us and you're like, well, they're diamonds. Like, I remember going to convention and I would walk past a diamond and I'd be like, you know, like your mouth is just wide open and you're like, I feel like I'm next to a celebrity. But y'all, the Lord can be with you in your pocket everywhere that you go. And when you have that bold faith and when you have that confidence in Him and in your team and in yourself and in your belief, it will show on the outside. It will show to your audience, to your family. If you've not revisited your why or have created a recent vision board, do that again. Share it within your team threads. But it takes you doing it first. You doing it first. You doing those things. You can't expect your team to do things when you're not doing them personally. Okay. I know that was a lot. Holy moly. Do y'all have any questions for us? Sally, can you think of any questions? I hope that those couple of systems and tricks help as far as, you know, with your team and all the things. I know Megan, I did not know that Megan Baxter was on your team, Sally. I love her so much.
We got some good ones.
For sure. You know, that's another thing too, is like pray about who the Lord wants to become part of your team. You don't need a team of 10,000 people, y'all. You need a couple people, and those couple people need to have integrity. They need to have morals. They don't need to be, you know, I feel like I got lost in this. Like, I want to save everybody. I want everybody to win. I bet you did the same thing, Sally. It's like, you want everybody to win and you want everybody to catch the vision, but like, that just doesn't happen. And that's okay. Like, you know, your intentions. And that's why those one-on-one coaching calls are really good. And just being intentional with sending those God-sized dream books or making your team feel valued and special and all the things.
Yeah, absolutely.
How did you sign 7 within the first few days? That is where I'm seeing diamonds filling their funnels, containing to build new connections. So yeah, I have already earned the walking pad. I will say this. I do a lot of interaction on social media. I add about 2 to 3 people every day. So what I like to do is, and y'all can write these things down, Sweet Honey Clothing, Bailey's Blossoms, Cheeky Plum, Pink Lily. There's a lot of different like pages. Like if you're a mama, you know, you follow like clothing for your daughter or for your son or whatever. I think there's one called Aspen and Company. Like there's so many different things. Well, a lot of those people are mamas. right? And so I'll go on there. I'll go on one of their posts, Pink Lily, Shop Impressions. I'll go on there. I'll go down through the likes and the comments. I'll click on them, see that they have a family. I'll add them as a friend. That is not weird. We're a social selling business, okay? And so I'll add them as a friend, and I'll just slowly connect with them on their stories, ask intentional questions, don't message them right away about Plexus, like intentionally build a little relationship for a couple weeks or so. I do a lot of stuff on my Instagram stories. Marissa L. Adams is my Instagram if y'all want to follow me, but I do a lot of like slide bar, like slide this bar, even a quiz. It doesn't have to be about Plexus. It could be, guess what my favorite food is, and do a quiz and like have something that people can engage with you on outside of Plexus. Okay. I noticed that I've been posting, by the way, twice a day for about a week now, probably since April 1st, and it is working. You know, used to, they'd say only post 3 to 4 posts a week about, you know, whatever on your feed, but post every day on your stories. Well, Jessica Heffley was like, no, post 2 or 3 times a day. I don't care. Just post. I have been doing that, and my inbox has been flooded. Okay. Like, but when that's the thing, like if you go and you are being intentional with your post and you are creating engagement, I would do an engagement post once a week. Engagement posts might look like, do y'all say supper or dinner? Or, you know, what's your favorite family beach vacation spot? Or, you know, last person to say happy before I say Friday gets a Starbucks gift card on me. One time I did that and I had like 7,000 comments. I was like, what the heck? This is a Starbucks gift card. Like, y'all are freaking out over some Starbucks. But it was crazy. And the engagement that I got from that when I went to my insights, it was like, whoa, so many more people are seeing your stuff. So I would do an engagement post once a week to boost your algorithm. What's happening a lot with a lot of y'all and a lot of people on our team I know is that you're seeing the same people's stuff over and over, and that's who you're engaging with. And so that's who's seeing your stuff, and that's why you're not getting any new people. So I would go and maybe unfollow a couple of Plexus people. You can still love on them and comment on their posts, but unfollow a couple people, unfollow some negative people, and there will be new people popping up in your newsfeed that you're like, whoa, where did they come from? Okay. It's not that nobody's joining your team and nobody's liking your stuff. It's that the same people are seeing your stuff and you need new people. Okay. I'm maxed out on friends. So literally every day, you only get 5,000 Facebook friends, just so y'all know. So y'all send those friend requests lightly. So I go and delete, like, I'll go and delete 5 people and then I'll add 2 or 3 people. And then I just engage there. But like, as far as earning the walking pad, I think being very intentional with following up. I love to send follow-up messages at night. I don't do them during the day. People are at work and they don't care about your pink drink. When it's at nighttime and they're tired and they're moody and they don't want to go to work the next day, they're going to be more apt to respond to you. So I've been sending follow-up messages. And then I include some before and afters, especially like with the reset, Triplex Balance. I'll say, hey, friend, I'm just checking on you. Are you still curious in these gut health supplements? These are some of my friend results from the Triplex Balance Reset Combo. I can always place an order for you. If you're anything like me, I know you're busy, but if you want me to send you a link, I can. I have a new discount code for April. What are your thoughts? And you give them a question. You end with a question so that they can respond to you. And then real quick, as far as phone calls, some of y'all are like, well, I ask people to get on the phone and they tell me no. That's because you're asking them to get on the phone. If I asked Jenny, hey, do you want to get on the phone for 10 minutes? No, that's weird. Nobody wants to get on the phone anymore. But if I say, hey, Jenny, do you have time tonight at 8:30 or does tomorrow at lunch work for you? Which one's better? Then it makes her choose. It makes her choose a time versus saying, hey, I want to get on the phone with you for 10 minutes. Well, I'm busy. Sorry. Like, that's weird. But if you give them a choice, then it makes them choose and they're more apt to say yes. Okay. Any other questions? Sally, do you have any questions? This has been so good, y'all. This has been so good.
It really has been so good. And I think especially for our team too, just a reminder of like, the cyclical way that this really is, and like to not allow yourself to be defeated, especially I think it's just when you've experienced momentum and then you go into a season, you're like, well, why isn't it like it was before? And it's like, you know, don't be Lot's wife. You know, we had a call about that last year. Like, stop looking backwards on how it was. Like, what is God, what are you, like you said, what is God teaching you now? Where are you at now? Who is God asking you to reach now? Who is God asking you to be now? And how is he asking you to trust him today to move forward? I love that. Do you feel like you spend equal amounts of time or more time on Facebook or Instagram?
I feel like Facebook is a lot more personal. I go live a lot on, you know, as far as like lives, I would definitely do that on Facebook. Instagram is like more fun. I feel like it's just more, a lot more trendy. I don't post everything on Instagram that I do on Facebook. I feel like Instagram is definitely more like your reels and your, you know, Instagram story, you know, where people can engage with you, that sort of thing. But Facebook, I do feel like, is more personal and you can tell more stories on there versus Instagram. But definitely utilize reels. I feel like there's a lot of emotion in reels. I know Sally does those a lot. There's a lot of emotion in reels. There's a lot of impact that you can make with a song. I mean, something as simple, like, I know I'm gonna shout out Megan Barham on our team. Like, she's been doing reels and they're so good about her just, you know, looking at her Bible or like having her quiet time. And like, it's so impactful. Like, throw a song on there and like, people watch that and people stop and like, they're like, this is so, it's like moving, you know, that story. There's nothing like storytelling.
I think that's just a really good reminder too, because sometimes I can be one track minded. And like, if I'm trying to focus on Instagram, then I like forget Facebook exists. And it's like, honestly, for the last 9 years, I still sign up 90% of my people through Facebook. And while I think it's important to use Instagram, especially for stories, because if people are on Instagram, they're flipping through their stories and the stories function and features are much better on Instagram and they transfer to Facebook stories, right? But like, that's, tonight's been a good reminder for me too, of just like, don't forget one or the other, like show up here because people are here and they're watching. But the right, personal stuff and where you're really your bread and butter of the interaction and the engagement and people that are going to actually speak to you in messages, for the most part, because 90% of us are not like influencers that are just getting inboxes from strangers. I'm like, what are you doing, girl? You know, that's great. Yeah. But both is fine and within a level, but to focus and like, don't forget, like Facebook is not dead. Like, that's where people are for sure.
And like, you can, you know, and I don't know if y'all do this a lot, but like in engaging on people's stories, those, if you go to your Facebook feed, your first 10, 20 stories are people that you're already engaging with. Does that make sense? So if you keep scrolling over and you're going to come across 5 or 6, maybe new mamas or new people that you've not connected with. And you can swipe up on their story and be like, oh my gosh, this is so precious. Where did you get that? Oh, she's so cute. I love this. You're such a good mama. Oh, I needed this encouragement today. Like, those are all, like, that's a social media tip. Like, I feel like those first 15, 20 people are people that you're already engaging with. And it's like, move out of my way. Let me get some of these people.
And that's where you're comfortable. Those are people we're comfortable. A lot of times it's our team or it's people that we like to follow, or we, you know, maybe people that are just in our lives already. And it's like, if we aren't seeing those strangers or those fringe friends that aren't ordering from us already, then it probably means we're not engaging with those people and they're not seeing our stuff. So that's really good.
We also do and we need to get back to this. We used to do it often, but we do a Love Dare challenge where we pick, like on Mondays, we'll pick 5 people or 3 people. Y'all can start with 3. And that Love Dare challenge is to reach out to them and say, hey, you were on my heart. I was just thinking about you. Is there anything specific that I can pray for you over today? You know, it's just crazy how the Holy Spirit will lead you to different people. And you crossed my mind. You guys will be amazed at the conversations that open up from that. The Love Dare challenge, and it can be scary, especially if you've never prayed over somebody or if you're not bold in that way. You know, I had a conversation with one of my girls and she was like, I sometimes feel like I'm not a qualified enough leader to pray over my people because I'm not spiritually where they are, where, you know, the Lord knows the desires of our heart and he knows where we are and he does not expect perfection. I love to hear people pray, even if it's, dear Lord, thank you for this day. Amen. Like my kids, you know, it's like the kids do this repetitive prayer, but it's like, he knows the desires of your heart. And so that Love Dare challenge can open up new conversation. It can open up just this confidence of them seeing you be bold and like stepping into, you know, what he wants over your life. So that could be something that y'all do, you know, on Mondays is a Love Dare challenge and say, let me know how many Love Dare messages you send today or something like that.
Yeah. And I think end of the day, ultimately that message that we can all just remind ourselves of is intentionality and action. Like choosing to not be fearful, choosing to not, you know, be confused, and just choosing to act and to be intentional with helping connect people to what we have and believing that we have something special worth stepping out on a limb for.
Yeah. Yes. Well, thank you, Sally. This has been amazing. I want to challenge y'all to make a post. If not tonight, tomorrow, make a post about what you took away from this call, where you want to go, what encouraged you. Go live this week with a friend. I better see all of y'all going live. Like, I love that. I love when you can just be bold and step into that. So share within your team threads what you took away. I'm so proud of all of you for getting on here on a Wednesday night and hanging out with us for an hour. This has been amazing. Thank you, Sally, so much.